O servants of Allah and O children of Adam, indeed, all praises belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and we seek Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's assistance and we seek His guidance subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we seek refuge in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the evils of our souls and the adverse consequences of our deeds. Whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decrees guidance upon, then none can misguide him. And whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decrees misguidance upon, then none can guide him. And peace and salutations be upon the final messenger, Muhammad ibn Abdullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, all praises belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for blessing us this day of Jumu'ah, a gift that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed the ummah of Muhammad ibn Abdullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with. A day in which Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said was prevented from being granted to nations before us. And a day in which those nations before us will be jealous of this ummah. A day which is considered the day of Eid in the week of a believer. Thus we find from the sunan of this particular day, acts that are found as part of the sunan on the day of Eid. And to make manifest how grand this day is, O servants of Allah, and O children of Adam, there is a hadith which I often repeat on the day of Jumu'ah, which is worthy of repetition. It's a hadith which is found in the Sahih and the other books of hadith and narrated by many Sahaba, such as Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu. In it, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, أَفْضَلُ يَوْمٍ طَلَعَتْ عَلَيْهِ الشَّمْسِ يَوْمْ الْجُمُعَةِ فِيهِ خُلِقَ آدَمٍ وفيه أدخل الجنة وفيه أخرج منها ولا تقوم الساعة إلا في يوم الجمعة. That the best day upon which the sun rises is the day of Jumu'ah. The best day upon which the sun rises is the day of Jumu'ah. On this day, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created Adam alayhi salam. And on this day, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala entered him into Jannah. And on this day, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala removed him from Jannah. And he says, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that the coming of the hour will not occur and happen except on the day of Jumu'ah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from the people of Jannah when the coming of the hour occurs. Ameen. O servants of Allah and O children of Adam, I have a topic to share with you all today that insha'Allah is the happiness of our life in this world and the next. And to introduce this topic, it must be said that the life that you and I live in this world is a dynamic one in terms of our connection to the hereafter, in terms of our relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in terms of our conformity to the teachings in the Quran and the Sunnah. It is a dynamic one. It's not a static one. For we have days in which we celebrate an iman high. And we find ourselves closer to the Quran and the Sunnah. And we find our eyes tearing much easier when we listen to the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we find a great love to follow immediately the teachings of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as soon as we hear it. And we have days of iman lows, days that make manifest our distance in terms of our attachment to the hereafter and in terms of our closeness to the Quran and the Sunnah and the teachings of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, days in which we hear the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but it does not affect us as it might have previously, or it might do in the future, bi'idhnillahi ta'ala. These are days where we experience an iman low. It's a dynamic relationship. It's not static. We won't have days, except if Allah has mercy upon us, until the end of our life, where we are upon an iman high. Nor will we have, inshallah, days until the end of our life where we are upon an iman low, inshallah. It's a dynamic one. And this is because, brothers and sisters, we are not living perpetual bliss and in a place called Jannah yet. And we are not living in perpetual doom or a place known as Jahannam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from this disastrous place. Ameen. Rather, we are living in a place that comes before. A place that is not an end in and of itself, but rather a means to an end. A place that is considered the temporary and exists before the perpetual. And this place is known as the dunya. A place of highs and a place of lows, as a servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala journeys to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is the reality of our life here. We are on a journey to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes this journey aptly in his book, Rabbul Izzati wal Jalal, Al-Wahid Al-Qahhar, Al-Ahad Al-Fard Al-Samad, Al-Ladhi Lam Yalid Walam Yulad, Walam Yakul Lahu Kufuwan Ahad. La ilaha illallah. He says subhanahu wa ta'ala, إنك كادح إلى ربك كدحا فملاقيه. الله أكبر. Allah likens our journey to him to a farmer that toils under the hot sun with his pick, tilling his land so that he can plant in order to ascertain a harvest. Our journey to Allah is similar to that farmer toiling away. Is that an easy task or a difficult one? It's a difficult one. And will or is he guaranteed reaping a harvest from his planting or not? This is something unknown to him. There are many variables. There are many anomalies. There are many factors. This is the reality of our journey to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So with this understanding, we learn that there will be days that are considered low days. And to further this understanding, understand that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us weak. We are prone to error, and we are prone to sin, and we are prone to falling. And thus Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَخُلِقَ الْإِنسَانُ ضَعِيفًا, that mankind has been created weak. خُلِقَ فِعْلْ مَبْنِي لِلْمَجْهُولِ. This is the passive form of the verb. That mankind has been created weak. Who has created mankind weak? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is the doer of the action. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has declared that he has created us weak. And this is why I say I have a topic today, O servants of Allah, and O children of Adam, that is the happiness of our life both in this world and the hereafter. For the topic for today is the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A topic that cannot be discussed in 10 or 15 minutes, but nonetheless a topic that must be shared time and time again as we traverse in this life, in our difficult journey to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and face the plight of shaitan on a daily basis as he tries to instill sadness in our hearts, as he tries to make us feel that we have lived our life in a way that is destined for doom and destruction. That we've lived our life in a way that has prevented us from earning that Jannah with Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And some even more sadder, that they feel that they do not have enough to even earn that Jannah. O servants of Allah, this is the topic of mercy and forgiveness. That topic that combats the ploy of shaitan. That topic that combats the depression of losing hope, of feeling that you don't have a chance, the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This mercy, O servants of Allah, and O children of Adam, dictates and necessitates that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most forgiving, the most merciful. For it is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who said, O servants of Allah, and O children of Adam, and I want you to pay close attention to this. Listen to what Allah, the most forgiving, the most merciful, has said Himself to instill happiness and contentment and serenity in our lives. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, نَبِّعْ عِبَادِي أَنِّي أَنَا الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ, that inform my slaves that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most forgiving, the most merciful. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. We need to celebrate this ayah. It shouldn't be an ayah that goes into one ear and leaves the next. It should be an ayah that enters us and penetrates our throats and enters our hearts and reforms our heart, because when the heart is reformed, the entire body becomes reformed. O servants of Allah, it is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who says in a hadith Qudsi, Yabna Adam, O son of Adam, إِنَّكُمْ تُخْطِئُونَ بِاللَّيْلِ وَالنَّهَارِ, indeed you sin throughout the day and you sin throughout the night. وَأَنَا أَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا, and it is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who forgives all sins. فَاسْتَغْفِرُونِ أَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ, thus seek forgiveness for your mistakes and consider your mistakes forgiven. Allahu Akbar. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling you and I, the children of Adam, it is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who says, يَبْنَ آدَمْ, O son of Adam, لَوْ بَلَغَتْ ذُنُوبُكَ أَنَانِ السَّمَاءِ ثُمَّ اسْتَغْفَرْتَ لِي لَغَفَرْتُهَا لَكَ وَلَا أُبَالِي. O son of Adam, if you sinned and sinned, you lived a life of sin that amassed to such a great amount that it reached the surfaces of the skies. Allahu Akbar. Imagine how many sins a person has to do to fill the atmosphere that they live in. Allah says, if you sin this much, ثُمَّ اسْتَغْفَرْتَ لِي لَغَفَرْتُهَا لَكَ, and then you sought forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, لَغَفَرْتُهَا لَكَ, Allah will forgive your sins for you, وَلَا أُبَالِي, and it won't even matter to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahu Akbar. It won't even matter to Allah. This is the mercy, O servants of Allah, that we need to be celebrating. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can forgive us irrespective of our mistakes, irrespective of our distance from the sunnah with regards to our wives, irrespective of our distance from the sunnah with regards to our children, irrespective of our distance from the sunnah with regards to ourselves and our communities and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and every aspect of this life that the Sharia has come to reform and came to reform. Despite our distance, understand, O servants of Allah, that as long as you are breathing, as long as you have not taken your final breath, understand that you have a right to earn the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through a process known as istighfar and seeking forgiveness, through a process known as tawbah and repenting. The people before us, O servants of Allah, and this makes us understand the mercy of Allah, they were a people who said, Yadullahi maghloola, the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are tied. They were a people who said, Inna Allah thalithu thalatha. They said, Allah is not one but three. They were a people who openly denied the instruction of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When they were commanded to go to a certain land and take that land from the oppressors, they told the Prophet that passed Allah's instruction to them, nay, we will stay, but rather you and your Lord go to that land and in effect do that job for us. Allahu musta'an. These were the statements of those before us. But the all-encompassing mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala dictated that Allah revealed and said, أَفَلَا يَتُوبُونَ إِلَى اللَّهِ وَيَسْتَغْفِرُونَ. Allahu Akbar. Allah said to them, will they not seek repentance for those grave sins? وَيَسْتَغْفِرُونَ, and seek forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What do we understand from this? That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying that whilst they were breathing, had they sought forgiveness for these grave statements and grave actions, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would have forgiven them. Allahu Akbar. So what about yourself and myself? Those who have declared the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and those who have accepted the prophecy of Muhammad ibn Abdullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is the message, O servants of Allah. Never lose hope in the mercy of Allah. Every breath you breathe is a reminder to you to turn back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and celebrate the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and acknowledge your belief in the names and qualities of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, especially the quality that He is At-Tawwab, Ar-Rahman, Al-Ghaffar, Al-Mannan, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who perpetually forgives and perpetually accepts repentance, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who can shower us with unimaginable gifts and unimaginable rewards. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the understanding. Ameen. O servants of Allah, and O children of Adam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed this ummah with mercy and blessed it with an opportunity for this ummah to be forgiven, as we have established. And this concept of seeking forgiveness, O servants of Allah and O children of Adam, was a sunnah from the sunan of the anbiya alayhim salatu was salam. It was a sunan, or it was a sunnah from the sunan of the anbiya alayhim salatu was salam. For it is established in the sunnah that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who was free from sin, would seek forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala 70 times in a day. And in a narration, more than 100 times in a day. This was the practice of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to teach us, O servants of Allah and O children of Adam, this amazing tool of hope that a believer must have in their lives. In the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions the dua of Nuh alayhi salam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that Nuh alayhi salam says, رَبِّ اغْفِرْ لِي وَلِوَالِدَيَّ وَلِمَنْ دَخَلَ بَيْتِيَ until the end of the ayah. Nuh alayhi salam makes dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive him and his parents and those that enter his home, and so on and so forth. And in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the fourth juz, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَكَأَيِّمْ مِن نَبِيٍّ قَاتَلْ. And in a riwayah, قُوتِلْ مَعْهُ رِبِّيُّونَ كَثِيرٌ فَمَا وَهَنُوا لِمَا أَصَابَهُمْ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ وَمَا ضَعُفُوا وَمَا اسْتَكَانُوا وَاللَّهُ يُحِبُّ. And then Allah says, وَمَا كَانَ قَوْلَهُمْ إِلَّا أَنْ قَالُوا رَبَّنَا اغْفِرْ لَنَا ذُنُوبَنَا وَإِسْرَافَنَا فِي أَمْرِنَا وَثَبِّتْ أَقْدَامَنَا وَانْصُرْنَا عَلَى الْقَوْمِ الْكَافِرِينَ. Allah says that the statements of the prophets, or there was never a time that a prophet came except that their statement was, رَبَّنَا اغْفِرْ لَنَا ذُنُوبَنَا. Oh, our Rabb, forgive our sins. Allahu Akbar. It was a sunnah from the sunan of the anbiya and something that they taught their people. O servants of Allah, also establishing the sunnah that encourages us to never lose hope in Allah is a famous hadith which we may have heard and love to hear. And that is the hadith where Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam teaches us of a slave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who makes a mistake and falls into sin. And the slave says, Rabbi, O my Rabb, أَذْنَبْتُ ذَنْبًا, I have sinned, فَغْفِرْ لِي, thus forgive me. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that when the slave says this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that my slave has understood, or my slave has made a mistake, and he sought forgiveness for his sin, and he is forgiven. And then the slave makes a sin again, and a mistake again. And he immediately turns to Allah and says, Rabbi, O my Rabb, أَثْنَبْتُ ذَنْبًا, I have made a mistake. I have committed a sin. فَغْفِرْ لِي, thus forgive me. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala announces that my slave has understood that he has a Rabb who is capable over him, and he has sought forgiveness for his mistake, and thus he is forgiven. And then the slave makes a mistake again, and he turns to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he says, Rabbi, O my Rabb, أَذْنَبْتُ ذَنْبًا, I have sinned, فَغْفِرْنِي, forgive me. Allahu Akbar, what does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala announce at this juncture, O servants of Allah? Does Allah forgive him? Indeed, Allah does, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala announces that my slave has understood that he has a Lord, he has a Rabb that is capable over him, and that this Rabb is the most forgiving, the most merciful. Thus he is forgiven and he can do as he pleases. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. This is the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How can we lose hope in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, O servants of Allah, when we hear these ahadith and when we hear these ayat in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? How can we feel that we are knocking the doors of death at 50 and at 60 and crossed our peak after 40 and we don't have a chance? How can we feel that, O servants of Allah? Indeed, never ever lose hope in the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and celebrate the ayah and the statement of Ya'qub alayhi salam when he said, as Allah teaches us, إِنَّهُ لَا يَيْأَسُ مِنْ رَوْحِ اللَّهِ إِلَّا الْقَوْمِ الْكَافِرُونَ, that no one loses hope in the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala except the disbelievers. May Allah make us from those who have constant hope. Ameen. O servants of Allah and O children of Adam, this is not a first class ticket on the best airline that you can think of towards sinning. Whilst we celebrate the hope of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is from the respect of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we try our best to stay away from sin. And when we make a mistake due to our weakness, we never lose hope in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But it is not a case where we plan sin and become deceived that we will be from the righteous after it, and become deceived that we will seek repentance for that sin after it. For by Allah, we don't know when the angel of death will meet us, whether he will meet us after that sin and we would have died with our last deed being a deed which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warned us against. So never ever plan sin. Try your best to stay away from sin. Take all the precautions and all the measures. And due to us naturally being weak, if we make a mistake and fall into sin, then turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and celebrate these ahadith and these ayat that we have discussed together. Walillahi alhamd. O servants of Allah and O children of Adam, the doors of Tawbah will not close except at two times. The first time is when a person breathes his last, when the soul reaches the point of gharghara. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَقْبَلُ التَّوْبَةَ الْعَبْدِ مَا لَمْ يُغَرْغِرْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept our Tawbah as long as the soul has not reached its last point of exit. And the doors of Tawbah shut when the sun rises in the west, a major sign from the signs of Qiyamah. As long as this has not happened, seek forgiveness. And don't wait till the day of Arafah. And don't wait for the last hour on the day of Jumu'ah. Al-mubadarah, al-mubadarah. Seek forgiveness immediately. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَسَارِعُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ, that race towards the forgiveness of your Rabb, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the understanding. From the outset, I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to shower upon us forgiveness, to make this a gathering that hears a good word and follows it, to make this a gathering that is forgiven upon its departure. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless us with death only when He is pleased with us, and Jannah is our abode. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us a grave which is a garden from the gardens of Jannah. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us a place underneath His arsh on the day of Qiyamah, and to grant us our books of good deeds in our right hands, and to grant us Jannah with Muhammad ibn Abdullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to inspire great hope in His mercy. Great hope in His mercy. And to protect us from the whispers of shaitan and ever becoming sad. Ameen.